Take off the Sandro, pay 5 day stay. Take a quarter meal, hella value. Take off the front flag, take off reception. Take off the cop with the iPad. Take off the allure, take off the unsure. Take off decisions I lack. Take off the fake deep, take off the fake woke. Take off the I'm broke, I care. Take off the gossip, take off the new logic. That if I'm rich, I'm real. Take off the shirt nail, take off the doge. Take off the broken bag. Take all that designer off and what do you have?
You out of pocket.
Huh. Two ATMs, you stepping to what?
You out of pocket.
Who you think they talk about? Talk about us.
You out of pocket.
Who you think they copy off us?
Get back in pocket.
The world in a panic, the women is stranded, the men on the run. The profits are vanished, the law take advantage. The market is crashing, the industry wants to sleep in the box while they making a mockery following us. This ain't monopoly, watching for love. This ain't monogamy, y'all getting pocketed. Jumping on what the hell is that? I gotta relax when I feel. All my descendants, they come in my sleep and say I am too real. I'm done with the sensitive, taking it personal. Done with the black and the white, the wrong and the right. You hoping for change and miracles. I know the feelings that came with burials, cries.
You ugly.
You out of pocket.
Two ATMs, you stepping to what?
You out of pocket.
Who you think they talk about? Talk about us.
You out of pocket.
Who you think they copy off us?
Serving up a look, dancing in a drop. Hello to the big step, but never lose account. Venting in the safe house. Venting in the safe.
Can I fill out my truth? I got nothing to lose. I got problems and pools. I can swim in my fate. Camera's moving whenever I'm moving. The family suing whatever I make. Murder is stacking. The president acting. The government taxing my funds in the bank. Homies ejecting the fence when I'm breaking. Look at my reaction. My pupils on skates. Hold up, hold up.
Let's think about this for a second. Tell me what you would do for steady. We show your shoulder on credit. We show your bro for leverage.
What a hypocrite said. What community feel they the only ones relevant? What a hypocrite said. What community feel they the only ones relevant?
You out of pocket, yeah, you out of pocket. You entertain the mediocre, need to stop it. You entertaining old friends when they toxic. What your life like? The gossip.
What the fuck is council culture, dog? Say what I want about you, I'm like overdog. I treat you like I'm Jigga, watch I own it all. Oh, you worry about a critic, that ain't protocol.
All right, my flow sinister.
It's the National Football League presented by EA Sports. Today, it's a Week 9 matchup set to go here between the Dallas Cowboys and the Los Angeles Rams. SoFi Stadium. And no return on this one as the fair catch is signaled for and taken. Take a shot right away. That's caught inside the 20. And they're going to get this down inside the 15. In today's NFL, you know, we talk about quarterbacks and their speed and accuracy, but there's still something about a guy slinging one downfield. A real field flipper there as all of a sudden they've got a first down in the red zone.
Hey, no field.
Now the first carry for Ezekiel Elliott. It's a 6-yard pickup, but it gets him to 2nd and 4.
A quick burst there, and he nicely bit off a pretty decent game.
It's a pickup of 6 that brings up 2nd and 4.
What are you doing? Were they even paying attention?
This is a second and four, ball at the nine. They're going to look to throw. He rifles one that's intercepted. It's the Honey Badger, Tyrann Mathieu. And the Rams are going to take over at their own 11-yard line. Well, it's no secret he's had trouble this year with interceptions, and this is a bad start for him. First drive, throwing another pick.
No matter who's broadcasting his game, that's how the conversation begins. Throwing too many interceptions. Can he take care of the football? If I were his backup, I'd be edging towards the coaches and saying, hey, how about giving me an opportunity?
So after the INT, it's Rodgers. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes in bounds. That'll go for a gain of seven, and it's second down.
Well, this defense for the Cowboys, they were excellent a week ago in the win over Pittsburgh.
Yeah, and what stood out to me on tape, the way they were flying to the football. So that tells me that they've got all their assignments down, and they're playing with extreme confidence.
Now a first carry for Derrick Henry. 9 yards to pick up there, and it's a first down. And the Rams at 7-1 now on the year. And they come in feeling pretty good after back-to-back victory, CD.
And I thought that they played pretty well last week. Their execution, their discipline, their resilience, all on display in that victory.
A solid run by Derrick Henry, and here's another first and 10. To throw, it's Rodgers. It's Kelce on the ground. So the completion good for seven there, and it'll be second down. I think defensively you're okay with that. Here in the first quarter, he's going to get some catches, but they rallied to him quickly.
And that's what you count on, and I like what you just said. First quarter, can you do it all game long? They catch it, you tackle them, they go down on the spot. Because when you're able to do that and you don't give up big chunks of yardage after the catch, now you put the offense in a position where every series they have to work hard to pick up first downs, and you tend to stall them out when you do that.
They'll get three as the drive continues. It's a first down.
It's nice every now and then in this game not to see people overthink it. Just hand it to the old reliable guy, let him pick up the first down.
Line of scrimmage, the 37 on first and 10. Again, it's Henry. And he puts his head down and gets up to the 42 for a gain of about six. Charles, they won last week despite him not running the ball well. They told us you need to get him going. Runs like that help.
And they talked to us about leaning on him because, as you noted, last week they didn't have to. Still won the ball game. They leaned on other people to give him the yardage that they needed. But they really want him to be that guy, and that's what they're doing early in this game.
Meanwhile, Rodgers' throw complete there to Moore. And out of bounds on the other side of midfield at the 45. So from Cowboy territory now, here's first and 10 at the 45-yard line. On play action, Rodgers. He's got his man on the crossing route. And he'll wind up getting this one all the way down inside the 20. He got 29 yards that time. Into the red zone, it's Rodgers. And that one's going to be off target and incomplete.
The coverage keyed in on him since that last completion his way. He earned a little more attention on that route, and that made it a lot tougher to get a clean throw his way.
Back to the air on second down, it's Rodgers. Throwing the out route here, and it's complete to Kelce. He's down inside the 10 to the 8, and it comes on a gain of 8. Really been an ideal start for them. They get the turnover on the opening possession. Now here they are moving the ball straight down the field on their first drive.
And that feels good, but you know on their side of the field, all they're thinking is, finish this drive off.
Oh, you saw that one coming. It's intercepted, thrown back across his body. Trayvon Diggs.
about set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. They take over here following the interception. That's the good news. The tough spot is the spot that they're in. That's inside the five in the shadow of their own goalposts here. First and 10. Call it a gain of 4 on first, and that'll make it second down.
And while they hope to continue this drive, it's really already mission accomplished. They've given enough space now that they have to punt the ball. They've done so with that first run.
10 seconds.
Second down, Elliott once more. And this time not as successful as he'll get back to the line of scrimmage and no more. No gain on the play, and it's going to bring up a third down. Well done to sniff that out defensively. He had it diagnosed pretty quickly.
I love that description because diagnosed is perfect on that one. Read his keys, made the play, and he couldn't even get going moving the football.
You're facing the prospect of a punt from their own end zone. They need some cushion. Let's see what they can do on third down. Back to throw. He'll get this complete to Jalen Reagor. And he'll be out of bounds near the 30. In fact, right on the 30. Excellent play there on third down. Give him 25 yards. So first and 10 now from the 30. From the shotgun, he'll look to throw. And his throw here is incomplete.
Certainly appeared to take away his first read, and by the time he tried to look elsewhere and find an open target, the coverage was too good. That one falls incomplete.
Okay, great.
Ball on the 30 as they come up second and 10. Look to throw here. Blitz coming and down he goes. We'll wind up losing it for 9 yards here on the sand. Now it's third down. You know darn well both of these teams reviewed the film and saw that this defense had 5 sacks last week. They got to keep their QB upright.
And they're going to try their best to do exactly that. But they're facing a team where getting to the quarterback is a mindset. It's a mantra for them. And they play a game within the game. And you know what it is? Let's race to the quarterback and see who gets there first.
And he's going to go down again. Kayvon Chaisson able to record his 5th sack of the season.
And that was a passer's nightmare. The front door totally shut down by the defense. So he kept going backwards, hoping to find another avenue of escape. It didn't exist.
On to punt now, Anger, as he boots this one away. Oh, look at the juke. It'll go as a 42, make it a 43-yard punt. 6 on the return, and the Rams will go on offense here with a 1st and 10. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Just the one misstep for them in the first half of the season. 7-1 is the record at the midway point. And in terms of, and now this is intercepted. My goodness. And the Cowboys are going to take possession here at their own 47-yard line.
Well, it doesn't take a whole lot of investigation to figure out why they're still sitting at 0 on the scoreboard, because their quarterback's got to wake up and start reading defense a heck of a lot better after throwing his 2nd interception.
He'll fire deep downfield from Lamb. That's caught inside the 20. And a big gain that time. He's out of bounds on what will be the final play of this first quarter. We're scoreless after one. So the big play means just like that, they'll operate from the red zone now on first down. Looking to throw. All right, rifles one, and that's going to be intercepted.
And the Rams are going to get the football here as he gets this up past the 20-yard line. Charles, not only is that an interception, it's one when you were really knocking on the door for a touchdown inside the red zone.
You're actually thinking points no matter what. At worst, you're thinking kicking a field goal and getting three. We might look back on this in the second half and say, you remember when they didn't get points on that drive? This could cost them.
Jabril Cox there on the tackle.
I don't think any of us were surprised that they decided to start this drive on the ground after the last two drives ended in interceptions.
Unfortunately, though, not a lot going on that first play.
Yeah, I think the anticipation was felt also by the defense.
The gain of 8 there on the play. And that'll bring up what looks to be a 3rd and inches. Can't be more than a half a foot. That's a staple of this offense. Drag route to the tight end.
Yeah, he's unable to use his size to break off much more yardage after the catch, but still an effective gain nonetheless.
And the Cowboys here on 3rd down bringing in an extra defensive back. They'll try to run for the first with Henry. And he's going to have a Rams first down as the tackle made about the 43-yard line. Well, after an interception, last thing you want to do is go 3 and out, give the ball right back. They avoided that.
Yeah, you definitely do not want to do that. I remember in college I played with a really big-time player on defense. We ended up getting an interception as we passed the offense coming out. He told him, if you don't take care of this football, you have to answer to me later. You definitely want to take care of it, pick up first downs.
And he's tackled at the 38, but they doubled their yardage. The play started at the 19, and they gained 19.
Well, that was a fun one to watch right there. A nice in-breaking route and plenty of room in the middle of the field. And he was able to get behind the linebackers and grab the completion for a really good pickup.
And they're going to work this down to about the 32-yard line. They were looking to throw, holding on the big right tackle.
That's real simple, partner. Keep your hands inside in the chest area. You're probably okay. You get it out on the shoulders, get them wide. Usually got to pick up a holding call.
So following the hold, they're in a bit of a hole here with a 1st and 20. Rodgers now to throw. The tight end Kelce has it over the middle. And he'll be brought down on the other side of midfield at the 43. 2nd and 15. Shotgun now for Rodgers. He'll get this complete to Cooper Kupp. And he's going to have another first down here as the tackle's made at the Cowboys' 22-yard line. A gain there of 21 yards. That's the number 2 receiver in the NFL in terms of yardage. And I'll tell you what, a few more plays like that, he won't be number 2 for long.
Well, that's what often happens when you have competitors run around the field. These guys know where they stand in relationship to yardage, totals, numbers, the whole deal. And let's face it.
And it's intercepted at the goal line. Picked off by Isaiah Rodgers. And the Cowboys are going to have the football here at their own 18-yard line. A nightmare of a first half for him. That's now 3 interceptions. But Charles, with his talent, if anyone can shake this off and right the ship, it's him.
I agree, because you don't get to be one of the best quarterbacks in the league without developing some major mental toughness. So I expect him to go in the locker room at halftime, hit the reset button, and come out a new guy in half number 2.
They start the drive with Lynch. Pass the 20 for a short gain, 2nd down.
Look, all any running back wants is a little bit of room, a little bit of space in order to maneuver. But he also understands how difficult it is for his offensive line up front. So if they give him any space, he realizes his job to make more out of it than what they give him. Picks up 3 on that carry.
A 2nd down pass play there, but it's incomplete.
I tell you, Brandon, this defense is playing with some confidence. Haven't allowed a point yet. Flying to the football. I'm telling you, it's almost 11 to the ball on every snap. Another nice job there to force an incompletion.
On 3rd down, he'll drop to throw. And that will be incomplete.
I know this offense was expecting to do big things, but it certainly hasn't turned out that way, at least not through the first 3 drives. They're definitely going to have to put their heads together and start concocting some offense that'll move the ball downfield.
Anger is on to punt, and he gets this one away. Very good return that time. 18 yards. And this offense will take over right at the midfield stripe with a 1st and 10.
Good starting field position for them as they come up first and 10 right at the 50-yard line. They go back to the air here after the INT on the last drive. That'll be caught by Cobb. And he's going to be taken down right at the 40-yard line.
Cooper Cobb. 10 yards on the pickup. It's second and inches.
A good spot to throw, and indeed they'll come out with four wide receivers here on second and inches. Running from the gun with Henry. And they'll be inside the 35 now at the 34-yard line. A gain of five, good enough for the first down.
Exactly what they needed right there, because they needed to use the ground game to take some pressure off, because the quarterback's been struggling a little bit.
They keep it with Henry on first down. 5 yards on the carry, good pickup on first down.
Oh, that was a thing of beauty right there. Look at how quick those blockers fired off the line once the ball was snapped. That was an O-line on a mission, all in sync. And the defense is lucky. That play only picked up 5 yards.
On second down, here's Henry. Runs over. 63 yards rushing for him as he has been tough to stop here this first half. Just a terrific run there, Charles, from a running back who is so compact and powerful. And that strength was on display there.
And with a guy his size, you have to know defensively that arm tackles aren't going to fly with him. You have to be able to wrap up, or else he can just brush tacklers aside like they're not even there.
And the next-gen stat shows us the tale of how much yardage he was able to pick up after the initial contact. Here we go now on first and goal. They'll try and run for it with Henry. And they'll get this from the 8 to the 5. Pickup of 3.
That's good power football on first and goal. A lot of teams will throw from there. But that's a nice job to chew up a few more yards and get yourself closer to the goal line.
Second quarter, 2 minutes to go. Tie ball game. A line of scrimmage once again, the 5, as they get ready for second and goal. Here's Rodgers. And he's going to go down just outside of the 5, right around the 6-yard line.
Multiple players combined for their team's first sack of the game.
The competition comes up in so many different ways. And right now, this unit, their competition is who's going to get to the quarterback the most times. They had about 5 sacks last week. We just saw their first one of this game.
Third and goal from the 6. Here's Henry. And he'll be brought down right on the edge of the goal line at about the 1-yard line. 4 yards, that gets them close to the goal line, but it also brings up a fourth and goal.
Well, let's see what they do. They're knocking on the door here in the second quarter.
And you know what you look at on your play sheet? Your 2-point conversion plays, because you've drawn up a number of them in today's football. You don't just have 1 or 2 for the game. You have more like 6 or 7. Which one do you like here? Because that's essentially what you're going for right now. That spot of the field, call one of those and go get 6.
Gay's kick is good. Terry's been automatic to this point of the season, and we can max on the 3-yard
line. The luxury it is to have a kick made in the back. Because he hasn't missed any yards. Converts on that one as well. And kudos to you. You didn't jinx him.
And a fair catch signaled for and taken successfully. Set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And with a little under a minute to go, they may try and work their way into field goal range and try to tie up this ball game. The first play of the drive there is incomplete.
Well, this defense is going to have to finish the job. There's still a second half that they have to play. But so far, an absolute total effort. They've disrupted the passing game, stressed the pocket for the quarterback. They forced him into errant throws. Everything they're doing has been executed well.
An incomplete pass leads to second and 10 from the 25. They'll drop the throw. He finds his man, complete. That's Ballard. Now the Cowboys are going to burn the first of their timeouts as they'll stop it with just over 40 seconds to go in the first half.
Fired that one in there, able to make connection on a nice in route.
With those faster passes when they're going that fast, any hesitation as a quarterback that the deflection, if you miss, might be bigger and lead to an interception?
Yeah, and the deflection works both ways. Maybe a defender gets a hand in the way and it pops in the air. And sometimes you throw it so hard your receiver can't handle it and he pops it up in the air for the defenders to grab as well.
But a moot point there is they were able to connect. A throw there, but that's going to wind up incomplete.
Well, based on what we've seen so far, I don't think you can even call this an off day anymore, partner, because this group we're watching, they are totally out of rhythm trying to get their game plan up and running. That zero on the scoreboard is glaring down at them with every incompletion.
He's been a busy man here in this first half as he gets it away. And this one will wind up being down just outside of that 20-yard line. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And they may just be content to take this three-point lead and head into the locker room. And defensively, they're just looking to keep him contained as they're able to get him down. 5 yards is the tally on first down. That brings up second and five. They'll keep it on the ground again here. And they'll take him down at the 31-yard line. So we've reached halftime. All we have to show for the first half, a lone field goal. 3-0, our score. As we send you to our EA Studios in Orlando, here's Jonathan Coachman with our EA Sports Halftime Report. Welcome back. Halftime over. We are ready for quarter number three. Alongside Charles Davis, I'm Brandon Gordon. The Rams going to get the football first here, and they look to build on their lead as the second half gets started. And that one will bounce out of the...
zone, so we will start here at the 25.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. But Charles, for them, pretty good first half on the ground. They had some success running the ball in quarters one and two, and they got the lead. Now a chance to expand upon that lead here with their first drive in the third quarter.
Yeah, and believe it or not, you and I have noticed that this great game of football has shifted towards pass first, run second. So for me, it's really nice to see some of these teams keeping the ground game as a big component of their offense, and it's working pretty well for them now. And let's face it, they can continue to do damage with it. And in addition, it sets up the pass game really well for them, too.
Going up top for Kupp. And he's got it. What a catch on the sideline. A gain of 37.
There's no doubt in my mind that not many guys in this league have had the impact that he's had here in the first half of the season. He's been a big play guy from the word go and continues to be one with another one right there.
And he can't find anywhere to go with it, and he goes down. Micah Parsons buries him for a loss of 11 from his outside linebacker spot. So second and long, and got to be careful not to fall out of field goal range. A shotgun handoff to Henry. Give him 4 yards there, but still in a big hole, third and long.
But that call makes sense because they've been throwing it well on this drive, and once again, they show passing formation, showing the shotgun. Then they ran out of it. That's a nice play by them defensively, though, to hold it to a short game.
Now on third and long, they'll look to throw. And this pass broken up. Excellent coverage there on third down, as that was not an easy one to hold on to. And Gay knocks this one through. And that will add three more to the lead. That pushes it up to six. Looking at it from a defensive perspective, that keeps the deficit very, very manageable. All things considered, not a bad job on the defensive side.
I would say that you've pointed out something pretty good right there, and that is you actually have both sides happy with that exchange. You know, happy in quotes, of course. One team, hey, we've kept it within range. The other side saying, hey, we put points on the board and did stretch out the lead. Let's see how this one turns out.
Yeah, still bottom line, though, 3 points for the opening drive of the third quarter. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And their deficit a little wider now than it was at halftime following the field goal a moment ago.
But the goal is still the same because you know they want to come out, establish a rhythm in the second half, and get going. Make no mistake about it, though. Kicking field goals, not in their game plan. They need to get the ball in the end zone.
And just 3 yards on the catch there. He couldn't get away. And it'll be second down.
They gave up the completion there, but this is what zone defenses count on. Catching the ball and not much run after the catch.
Here's a second and 7. Sideline throw, it's complete. And a nice job there of keeping the toes inbounds.
I do have to admit, I like it when it all comes together. When the top part, catching the football, right, whether you're catching it with your hands or cradling it, comes together with the legs, in this case, the feet, did a little toe tap to stay in bounds and complete the catch.
And a great job by our crew on the camera shot. Love when you see the grass or on the field turf, those rubber pellets flying up. Great catch. And past the 40 before he's out of bounds. 11 yards and a Cowboy first down.
Caught that look from you there, partner. I think we're on the same page on that one. Just his first catch. I think we both thought he'd be a little more active in the passing game. Let's see if that's the start of them trying to get the ball to him a little bit more here in the second half.
And they'll get him down on the other side of midfield.
Good, sure hands there from a guy not accustomed to catching a whole lot of passes. But how about the way he was able to pull that one in and pick up good yardage?
A play action fake. They'll look to throw. He finds his man complete. It's Ferguson. And this is going to be another first down as the tackle's going to be made at the Rams' 34-yard line. Give them 15 there, and the Cowboys have a first. Still in search of their first touchdown of the game, but they're on the move, first and 10. A first down carry by Elliott. 3 yards on the pickup there, and it'll be second down.
I have to think a major focus of the halftime meetings had to be figuring out how to create space for the running game to get operating.
Well, you pointed out to me at half, seems accurate. That line has struggled to sustain blocks.
Yeah, I would agree with that totally. They've got to focus on staying on their double teams at the first level, make sure that block's secured before they slide off and try and chip someone at the second level.
He finds his man complete. It's Ballard. And they move this all the way down to the 9. A good pickup there, 21 yards. That's what we're used to seeing from him right there. Plays like that, why he's number 4 in the league in terms of receiving yardage.
Able to make adjustments all along the way. Doesn't matter where he lines up, where he releases from. Working his way into the secondary, figures out defenses and finds weak spots in order to get open.
And he's able to get it down to the 2-yard line. The improv on the scramble there gets him 6, and it'll be second down. They'll try to run it in with Elliott. And he is met in his tracks behind the line of scrimmage. Big play coming here. It's third and goal. He'll drop to throw. Pressure, down he goes. Sacked at the 10.
Aaron Donald with a big-time sack on third down. It's a loss of seven. The kick by Marr is good.
Well, I don't know if they would have gone for it on fourth and goal anyway, but the sack on third down pretty much made their mind up for it.
You're exactly right about that, and this is a tough place on the field to take a sack because, as you just noted, it took the decision-making away from them. Now they have to go for a field goal instead of potentially going for it.
Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. Now this game, it has obviously been all about the defense on both sides of the football. Which offense is going to break through here? We'll see if they can do it on this drive.
Buried by multiple defenders on the drive's first play.
Well, he shot in, CD, like he was out of a cannon from that linebacker position. And even though they had a running back in the backfield, no one could stop him.
Well, you certainly diagnosed that play perfectly because as fast as he got into the backfield, you're exactly right. The running back had no shot to get over and try to protect his quarterback, and a sack resulted.
They try to throw on second down, but this one is incomplete. And Charles got to like what this defense has been able to do these last couple of plays.
Yeah, they get the sack on first down, then they force the incomplete pass. Now they're just a play away from getting the football right back. But it's a big play. They've got to hold up.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. Rodgers going to throw. To the right side, it's Kelce. And a good job defensively. They stop him short of the first at the 32. They pick up 10, but it'll still lead to a fourth down. Here comes the Rams punter now, as he's on to punt for the first time this afternoon. He was called on three times in the win last week as his first one here is away. A 41-yard punt there with no return. And the Cowboys will take over the football with a first and 10. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. And Charles, we've seen almost three full quarters now, and neither offense can really get it going. Neither has hit the end zone, and neither side seemingly can make that big play.
But the game hasn't been devoid of action because these two defenses, they've taken over and they've slugged it out. But I think you're exactly right. We're at that stage of the game now where one of these offenses, if they make a big play, that could be the difference.
Twice as difficult now after the sack. It's second and 20. They'll set up to throw. He'll fire deep downfield for Lamb. And that's going to be incomplete. Good effort there trying to take a shot, but it's third down.
We've seen that the deep ball has been a part of their game plan all afternoon, but they've had trouble hooking up on it, unable to successfully find the end zone over the top.
The Cowboys on third down. They've converted just 2 for 6 thus far. This will be third and forever. Now back to throw. And he will not be able to hang on to the contact. It's incomplete. The coverage strong, and now it's fourth down. Here's Brian Anger now. As the drive goes backwards, so he's on to punt it away. He's averaging just under 50 yards a punt as he gets this away. 42-yard punt, 6 on the return. And they will take over first and 10.
set to begin their next drive. The Rams offense at the line. Their defense got the stop, forced the punt, and now you really start to monitor the clock as they nurse this slim lead. And he'll manage to break a tackle and get this forward for a couple. It'll be second down.
You've got to be impressed by that defensive front on reps like those. They were not being moved off the line, kept their shoulders square, and gave their teammates time to fight to the ball and limit that game.
Second down, they go again with Henry. Oh, it goes over him. And he'll go down, but not before getting this inside the 30. 121 yards rushing for him now as he has been tremendous all day long.
Well, that's a carry they have to be satisfied with. And throughout this game, they've been satisfied with what he's given them. Whenever they've needed a big run, a first down, he's the guy they've turned to. And it doesn't matter what the defense thinks. They feel like they've got the confidence to keep handing it to him and keep picking up good yardage.
And he'll get this one down to about the 27. 2 yards on the pickup there. It'll be second and 8.
Let's just make this one succinct. Nice job there. All 11 guys on defense diagnosing the jet sweep and putting it down.
Henry will get it. He's been busy today. It's a 4-yard pickup there, and it leaves him with 3rd and 5. The recipe's pretty simple, I think, right? Just give your superstar the ball, continue to feed him.
Don't overthink this one, right? Make sure he's touching the football, but you're also counting on his intelligence in playing the game as well. If it's not there, don't force the run. Just make sure you hang on to the football and keep the clock ticking.
And he'll be marked down right at the 15-yard line.
See the receiver try to run down the defender, meaning goes right at him, and really trying to move him a little bit towards the center of the field so he can put his foot in the ground and break to the out to the sideline and make a catch.
That's going to wind up a loss of a full 3 yards on first down.
Well, that was one of the few times they've been able to contain him thus far. He's over 100 yards for the game, but he lost a bit off his total on that carry.
If nothing else, they've already taken a couple minutes off the clock here already as they come up second down. And look at this. They get the turnover they needed. It's intercepted. And the Cowboys are right back in this football game. A critical error there in a tight game of the fourth.
All you talk about is taking care of the football, and especially with a lead here in the fourth quarter. Turning it over, now the door is open for the opposition.
Just in general, when you're passing in the fourth quarter with a lead, no matter what point, you got to be super careful.
Got to be careful, and sometimes you can be so careful that you end up running yourself into an error.
Just a yard on the first down carry, so it's 2nd and 9. They're going to look to throw. Nothing open downfield, so he'll throw it away. A misconnection there. He's hit on just 50% of his passes thus far. That's not where you want to be.
Now you see the evolution of the game. You go back to the quarterbacks of old, 50% would be terrific because they threw the ball downfield almost every time they threw it. Now with a short passing game, you should be above 60% just to be in the average range.
Throw. And incomplete on the deep ball.
We've seen these defenses make enough opportunistic plays to keep this one low scoring. Flying around, making plays on the ball, and we see yet another errant throw as a result.
Here's Brian Anger now, standing just outside his own goal line. And he deserves a bronze leg as he gets this one away. And this will be down by a member of the kicking team just outside of the 30-yard line. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. They're holding on right now to that slim advantage in a one-score game, and you hear a lot about two-minute offense and four-minute offense. Obviously, the four-minute offense applies here. How do they run that effectively?
Yeah, really what the four-minute offense is you're just trying to grind the clock. So you want consistent gains, steady gains. Doesn't have to be big plays, but it has to be plays that gets first downs and keeps the ball away from your opponent.
But certainly throwing the ball is in the mix here.
It certainly is. Just make sure that you're careful with it. And again, get those first downs, keep possession of the football.
Play action. Now it's Rodgers.
He finds his target. It's Schultz. And he slips up past the 45 before being tackled. First target, first catch, and a first down.
Now he came into this game within shouting distance of Dan Marino at 61,361 career yards. And with that last play, Charles, he just went past Dan Marino.
I'm struggling over here. And the only reason is when you hear about him passing a Dan Marino,
a legend,
makes you step back and really take stock of his career. And you realize it's not just about the numbers. It's about the accomplishments. It's about the play. How great has his career been to pass Dan Marino? I'd say pretty darn great.
A 20th carry now for Derrick Henry. And he'll go down here right around the 23-yard line.
132 yards rushing for him now as his sensational afternoon continues.
Well, partner, I know this type of running back. I mean, this size, this intensity usually gets better as the game goes on. I just tell you from experience, the first few quarters, oh, you're eager. You come running up there, I'm going to tackle this guy. By the fourth quarter, you're coming up and thinking about it.
And D-line wearing down fourth quarter. Yeah, that's not a guy they want to see consistently.
Now, obviously, that's some good work there defensively, being able to stop them and bring up a key third down. But if you're on the offensive side of the ball, there's an opportunity, because I know what defensive guys are thinking right now, to stop them, get to the ball. That means they might not be sound defensively. There could be some opportunities.
And you said key third down. Highlight that word. Put it in bold. Here we go.
With his size, he's a tough man to bring down, but they do a nice job there stopping his progress and not allowing him to get back to the line of scrimmage.
Rodgers gonna go on fourth down. And he's brought down. Can't do anything with a football. It's a sack and a turnover on downs. From the 34 now, here's first and 10. Back to throw. Throw left side complete. That's Ballard. And they're able to work this across midfield to the 48.
Now you're right on the edge of field goal range. You've still got time, but get up to the line of scrimmage and get set.
He's back to throw. And he can't get a throw away. He's taken down. Taken down for the fifth time this game. Multiple defenders there to get him. This defense, they just continue to feast. Five sacks now as a unit. It's been quite an afternoon getting to the quarterback.
And we're seeing it come from a variety of places as well. Sometimes just the guys up front getting to him. Other times you add extra guys rushing the quarterback, twists and stunts. It's been a variety, and they've had no way of blocking them.
An incomplete pass on that last play, and that means they'll need to come up with something here on third down. They'll look to throw. He's going to let it fly. And that will be incomplete. They weren't scared to let it fly, but it falls to the ground and brings up fourth down.
Finally, they've got one chance left to keep this one going, and I think for you and me, let's think along with their offensive coordinator now, has to think back, cycle through every play of this contest, and remember what's worked and what hasn't. Because right here, he needs the best play of the game in order to keep this one alive.
He finds his man complete. It's Ballard. And unable to break away, they stop him a few yards shy. They had to go for it with such little time remaining, and that will force a turnover on downs. Set to begin their next drive, the Rams offense at the line. And three timeouts remaining here defensively, but really not much reason to use them at this point as this one is all but over.
If they use the timeouts here, it's strictly for show. We got plenty to catch.
So they'll come up after the gain of 7 on a 2nd and 3. They'll run it again with Henry. And just 1 yard here from the 49 to the 50. The Cowboys going to use their second timeout now as the clock will stop with an even 20 seconds left to go. I guess the simple question, why not just take a knee there?
I don't understand either why you would take any sort of a chance. We've seen it happen in the game of football. Doesn't matter whether you watch high school, college, or the NFL. Some people get...
And he can't get a throw off. He's taken down. What a huge play at this point in the game.
This is a little hard for me to compute because I'm watching sack after sack happen, but somehow they're still behind in the game. I would expect all of this defensive pressure to translate to them taking a lead, and thus far, it hasn't happened. Time's winding down. They don't want to waste this type of performance from these ace pass rushers.
They call it 38 yards on the punt, no return. And control of the football, switching hands here with very little time remaining in this contest. About set for this next drive by the Cowboys offense. Their defense has done the job. Now it's the offense's turn as they've got it first and 10. Now a desperation throw deep downfield. Batted by the safety but caught anyway. A big connection on that one. 58 yards. Well, it took us until the final play just officially decided to win. I know that last play was so backed up that we would have taken a miracle.